our education, dear student, in earlier you learn about the triangles, different types of triangles and quadrilaterals also. So today we will discuss about quadrilaterals of class 9. Here we will little bit discuss about the quadrilateral and the different types of quadrilateral. Dear students, you know what is quadrilateral? Quadrilateral is a four-sided closed figure. Okay, so I am constructing one figure of quadrilateral. Here you see ABCD is a quadrilateral having four sides. Okay, first one, four sides. What are they? AB, BC, CD and DE, and four angles. What are they? Angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. There are also four vertices. What are the four vertices? A, B, C and D are four vertices here. And also we will see another point, that is diagonal. AC and BD are two diagonal. So you may say, what is diagonal? The line segment joining two opposite vertices is called the diagonal. So finally we will have to remember, quadrilateral have 10 elements. Okay, so 10 elements, that is 4 sides, 4 angle and 2 diagonals. So next we will discuss another varieties of quadrilateral. So this is one variety of quadrilateral, let it be ABCD. Another variety, suppose it may look like this. It may be named as PQRS. Here in PQRS quadrilateral, R angle is a reflex angle, but in figure A we will see all angles are less than 180 degree. So first one is called convex quadrilateral and second one is called concave quadrilateral. Concave quadrilateral. So we say, what is the definition of convex quadrilateral? The quadrilateral whose each angle is less than 180 degree is called a convex quadrilateral. And what is concave quadrilateral? We'll say the quadrilateral whose one angle is greater than 180 degree. Another point also we'll say on both of them. In convex quadrilateral, the two diagonals are inside of it. But here in concave quadrilateral, one diagonal is outside of it. So we have to remember one thing, that we are not learning about concave quadrilateral at all. We are learning about the convex quadrilateral. Okay? So next we'll discuss the types of quadrilateral. You all know quadrilaterals are of different types, like parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, square, kite and trapezium. So dear students, you all know About different types of quadrilaterals like parallelogram, etc. So we'll recall about them, rectangle, rhombus, and the properties here. So first we'll discuss about parallelogram. So you see, parallelogram. Definition of parallelogram says the quadrilateral whose opposite sides are parallel to each other. That is AB parallel to CD and AD parallel to BC. Okay, so this is the parallelogram. You will say, what are the properties of parallelogram? First property is the opposite angles are equal. That is, A angle is equal to C angle and B angle equal to D angle. Okay? And second point, we'll say opposite sides are equal. That is, AD equal to BC and AB equal to DC. Next property, the sum of two adjacent angles is supplementary. Next property will say the two diagonals AC and BD bisects each other. Means suppose they bisect at O, here OA equal to OC and OD equal to OB. So dear students, now next we'll discuss about rectangle. So what is rectangle? The parallelogram which each angle is 90 degree is called a rectangle. Let PQRS is a rectangle which each angle is equal to 90 degree and opposite sides are equal as well as parallel to each other. And here we will see the two diagonals PR and SQ are equal. Here equal to SQ. Okay, and they are also bisecting at a point. Let it be O. So now next we'll come to rhombus. So what is rhombus? We can say the parallelogram which all sides are of equal length. So let it be like this. Sorry. Let it be A, B, C, D, rhombus which all sides are equal and opposite sides are also parallel to each other. In rhombus, four sides are equal and the two diagonals AC and BD perpendicularly bisects each other. That is, you can say OA equal to OC, OD equal to OB, and the two diagonal AC and BD bisects at right angle means makes 90 degree at the points of bisection. So next come to the kite. So what is kite? Kite is a type of quadrilateral which one pair of adjacent sides आर इक्वल इन मेजर बट ऑपोजिट्स आर साइड्स आर नॉट इक्वल इन मेजर. सो लेट ए बी सी डी इज द काइट वेयर ए बी साइड एंड ए डी साइड आर इक्वल. Also, we can say BC equals to CD. Okay, and the two diagonals AC and BD intersects at right angle to each other. Now, next we'll discuss about trapezium. Dear student, you know trapezium is also a type of quadrilateral whose one pair of parallel side and another sides, another pair of sides are not parallel. So we'll write here AD parallel to BC and can say the definition that the quadrilateral having a pair of parallel sides is called trapezium. Now come to next point, that is square. You know square is a four-sided closed figure whose all sides are equal in measure and each angle is 90 degree. Also we can say the parallelogram whose all sides are equal and each angle is 90 degree. Also we can change and say the rhombus whose each angle is 90 degree is a square. So let us draw a figure of a square. Let it be a BCD. Here we know the two diagonals AC and BD bisects perpendicularly each other and OD equal to OB, OA equal to OC, and also the length of diagonal AC equal to BD. All sides are also equal and each angle 90 degree. Then students will discuss about angle sum property of a quadrilateral. You know students about the angle sum property of triangle, that is sum of three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So now we'll prove. First, using the properties of angle sum property of a triangle to get the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. So this is the quadrilateral ABCD and we join one diagonal AC here. After joining the diagonal AC, quadrilateral divide into two triangles, that is the triangle ABC and triangle ABC. Okay, so see here, we'll use first the angle sum property of a triangle, then using this property we'll find out angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Now see here, in triangle ABC, see What are the angles? There is angle ABC plus angle BAC plus angle ACB. The sum of three is equal to 180 degree. One. Then come to triangle ADC. Here also sum of three angles is equal to 180 degree. That is DAC angle plus ADC angle plus ACD angle equal to 180 degree. That is 2. So dear student, now we'll add 1 and 2. So we'll write adding 1 and 2. We'll add left sides with left sides of 1 and 2. Similarly, right side value with right side value. That is ABC plus BAC plus ACB plus DAC plus ADC plus SCD equal to 360 degree. DAC and BAC will together add up to get A angle. Similarly, BCA and DCA add up to get C angle. Now we'll mix them. ABC angle remain, but BAC in place of BAC will take DAC. So this is common together. Then angle DCB or DCA plus BCA will take together plus ADC equal to 360 degree. Now come here, ABC angle plus BAC plus DAC add up to get DAB. DAB plus DCA and BCA make up DCB. DCB angle plus ADC angle equal to 360 degree. So we know angle sum property of quadrilateral is the sum of four angles is equal to 360 degree. Dear student, today's class is over. For the next classes, we'll discuss about the theorems related to the quadrilateral. And for latest notifications, you have to like, share, subscribe and press the bell icon for next updated videos. Thank you.